e-learning module presented by ETDC Vijayawada SC Railway. Topic is power circuit in three phase locos regarding traction converters and auxiliary converters. Initially, the supply from OHG, whenever we will raise the pantograph through roof bars, three roof bars are provided, two straight roof bars which are connected to the pantograph, one and two, and one center roof bar, cross roof bar. In the middle is available. Whenever we will raise the pantograph, the supply from OHG through pantograph and through straight roof bar and a HP link, the supply will come to the cross roof bar, middle roof bar. From middle roof bar, the supply will initially will come to the PT, potential transformer. Further, it will step down and will be supplied to the MVR, minimum voltage relay, which was available as B1 panel, and U meters, OHG meters, available in the cavern and cap 2, and SR electronics. So the PT supply will goes to the MVR, U meter, and SR 1 and 2 electronics.
Through PT fuse.
Here we can see roof of three phase loco pantographs, two pantographs are provided. When you raise the pantograph, the supply from OHG through pantograph to straight roof bar, two straight roof bars, each one connected to the pantograph. And through HPD link. So HPD link connected between straight roof bar and cross roof bar. This is the HPD link. In case of panto damage, if you want to remove the HPD link, so in case of panto damage, to remove the HPD link, we have to turn like this and we have to keep in the earthing heel provided on the roof of the loco. The supply which is coming to the center roof bar, it goes to the PT, potential transformer. From where MVR and U meters and SR1, SR2 electronics. When you raise the panto, the supply will goes to the PT. Before closing of VCB, we can came to know OHG available and ET1. Connected to the center roof bar before VCB. Here the supply is going to the VCB. Before VCB, ET1 was connected. Any surge voltages before closing of VCB, it will be grounded. ET2 connected after VCB. If any surge voltage is after closing of VCB through ET2 will be grounded. ET1, ET2 are gapless surge arresters. Here we can see HVM handles. Whenever we will operate HVM, two arms, one arm will be connected to the equipments before PCB, and one arm was connected to the equipments after PCB. So roof equipments, pantograph, HVD links, all will be grounded through one arm, and transformer, the supply and transformer equipments will be connected to the ground through one more arm, ET1, is connected before VCB. ET2 is connected after VCB. If any surge voltages before VCB closing, through ET1 the supply will be grounded. If any surge voltages after closing of VCB
through
ET2 will be grounded. You can see here HVM, grounding switch for climbing on the loco roof, for attending any problem in the loco roof. We have to inform TPC. TRD staff will come. They will take the power block. So we have to secure the loco. We have to ground along with the TRD staff. We have to climb on the loco roof. We have to attend the problem. For grounding, secure the loco, lower the pant, ensure both pantos in lower condition, take the key, IZ38 key, or we can call blue Kaaba key, or grounding key from pneumatic panel. Place the key in blue socket in HVM box, insert horizontally and turn to vertical, then unlatch the handle. Here latching provision is there, locking provision, just unlatch, then turn HVM handle 180 degrees, turn the fidget keys, take one of the fidget key, turn from vertical to horizontal, take one of the fidget key, keep in our custody. When you turn the HVM handle, so two arms on loco roof will be lifted up, one arm will close before VCB and one arm will close after VCB. So roof equipments and loco equipments, transformer equipments will be grounded. So ungrounding, keep fidget key in the yellow socket which was removed and turn to the normal position, then handle from grounding position to ungrounding position, turn again 180 degrees in reverse direction after removing the latch. Then we can turn the IZ38 key to the normal, then keep in pneumatic panel. Supply from Panto through VCB through OCR, over current relay in feeding power circuit, just like QLM in conventional locos. If any over current relay in feeding power circuit, this OCR, we call this as OCR70H, will come into the service and disable trip put through OCR. OCR70H, a mechanical locking relay available in SB1 panel. You can see here OCR 78. It's like 12M mechanical locking OCR 78 available in SB1 panel. To product any over current in feeding power circuit, the supply in the main transformer winding will step down. The supply will be given to the traction converters 1 and 2. Traction converters 1 and 2 will convert single phase AC supply to 3 phase, and that 3 phase supply will be given to the traction motors. In traction converters, 3 parts are there: one rectifier, line converter controlled by NSC, DC link, and inverter, drive converter controlled by ASC. So in line converter, the single phase AC supply will be converted into DC. The DC will be stabilized in the DC link. And inverter DC supply will be converted into the 3-phase AC. That 3-phase supply will be given to the traction motors. In case of AAG9, 6 traction motors are available. From converter 1, traction converter 1, traction motor 1, 2, 3 will get supply. From traction converter 2, the supply will be given to the traction motor 4, 5, 6. In case of AAG9 and AAP7. In case of AAP5, from traction converter number 1, TM 1 and 2 will get supply. From traction converter 2, TM 3 and 4 will get supply. Because in AAP5, only 4 traction motors are available, Bobo type bogey, only 4 traction motors are available in AAP5. So the output of the inverter is 3 phase, 2180 voltage. Here input is each 1269 voltage, 2 windings. So both are connected in series. The output is the variable voltage, variable frequency. Voltage varies from 0 to 2180 voltage and frequency 65 to 132 hertz. In traction converters, 2 types of converters are there: GTO and IGBT. GTO, EP contactors are available. So in IGBT, EM contactors are available. In GTO, for starting of this converter, so EP contactor has to close. Pneumatic supply was required. This supply will be given through a EP cock, which was available by the side of the pneumatic panel. This cock should be open for SR1, SR2. In case of GTO type traction converters, in GTO we cannot isolate individual traction motors. So we can isolate one truck of traction motors by a switch 154, or it's a concerned SR breaker 127.2/1. But in IGBT, The system can isolate individual traction motors. So individual traction motor isolation facility is available in the IGBT locos. In traction converters, we already said two types of converters are there. One is GTO type and IGBT. GTO, gate turn off technology. In GTO type, in dry converter AC, only one cord will controls all three traction motors. So in case of any problem, we cannot isolate individual traction motors, we have to isolate truck. One truck of traction motors we have to isolate in case of GTO. In IGBT locus, insulated gate bipolar transistor locus, IGBT SRs, in drive converter, each traction motor was controlled by individual cord. So if any abnormality, we can isolate traction motor. At present, the system will isolate individual traction motors. So this, if any over temperature or speed sensor problem, the traction motor will be isolated by the system itself. But GTO, we have to isolate truck. Here individual traction motor can be isolated by the system. Here you can see converter 1, converter 2. Converter 1, line converter controlled by NSC, and drive converter controlled by AC. The total SR, line converter, DC link and drive converter controlled by SLG and ALG. Two traction converters, traction converter 1 and 2. So converter 1 will give supply to the traction motor 1, 2, 3. Converter 2 will give the supply to the traction motor 4, 5, 6. For any hormones, in traction power winding, will be suppressed by harmonic filter. Harmonic filter is a combination of one conductor, one resistance, one capacitor. Resistance is provided on loco roof, cooled by atmospheric air. Next, the supply from main winding will be stepped down to auxiliary winding. 1000 volts. This from axle winding, the supply goes to the three axle converters. Auxiliary converter number 1 available in bar 1, which was located in machine room number 1. Auxiliary converter 2 and auxiliary converter 3 located in inside bar 2, located in machine room number 2. Auxiliary converter 1 we can call as bar 1, auxiliary converter 2 we can call as bar 2, and auxiliary converter 3 we can call as bar 3 also. This axial converters will convert single phase AC supply to three phase. This axial converter is a combination of rectifier, AC link and inverter. The output will be three phase 415 voltage variable frequency. The output of axial converter 1 will be given to the oil cooling blower number 1, oil cooling blower number 2. The output of axially converted 2 will be given to the TMB 1, TMB 2, TFP pump 1, TFP pump 2, traction converter pump 1, traction converter pump 2. The output of axially converted 3 is given to the scavenging blower number 1, scavenging blower number 2, main compressor 1 and main compressor 2, battery charger. Cooling system we will see. In three phase loco, a transformer is provided under truck. The transformer oil was circulated by two pumps, TFP pump 1 and pump 2. TFP pump will circulate the transformer oil to the radiator 1 and that is OCB unit 1, and TFP pump 2 is circulated the transformer oil to the radiator in OCB 2 and back to the transformer tank. Two SRs are provided. GTV loco, GTO type SRs. Oil cooling system is there. IGPT SRs, water coolant system is there. SR pump 1 and pump 2 will circulate the SR oil or water coolant from SR to the OCB unit and back to the SR. Similarly, SR 2 will circulate SR2 oil to the OCB unit 2 and back to SR2. These radiators, transformer oil, SR oil or water coolant was cooled by OCB, oil cooling blower. Just like MVRH in conventional. The air will be taken from the roof through a filter. It will cool the radiators of SR and transformer oil. Scavenging blowers, three phase scavenging blowers. Three phase scavenging blowers. They will clean the dust from filters of OCB oil cooling blower and TMB filters. So TMB 1, TMB 2 will get supply from axial converter 1 for cooling of traction motors. They will take the air from the atmosphere and they will cool the traction motors. The air will be admitted through a filter. This TMB filter and OCB filters are cleaned by scavenging blowers, three phase scavenging blowers 1 and 2. In normal condition, axially converter number 1 feeds OCB 1, OCB 2. All cooling blower number 1, blower number 2. OCB 1 located in machine room 1 to cool transformer oil and SR 1 oil or water coolant. Similarly, OCB 2 in machine room number 2 to cool transformer oil and traction converter 2, SR 2 oil or water coolant. Was controlled by MCBs 59.1 bar 1 for OCB 1, 59.1 bar 2 for OCB 2, provided in HB 1, HB 2 panels. Axial converter 2 will feed TMB 1 and TMB 2, TFP pump 1, pump 2, traction converter oil pump 1 and traction converter oil pump 2. TMB 1, TMB 2. just like MEMT1, MEMT2, TMB1 to cool traction motors 1, 2, 3, TMB2 to cool traction motors 4, 5, 6. TMB1 was available in machine room 2, TMB2 is available in machine room number 1, controlled by MCPs 53.1-1 and 1-2, provided in HB1, HB2. Transformer oil pump number 1, provided in under truck. TFP pump 1 below machine room number 1, TFP pump 2 below machine number 2 to circulate the transformer oil to the cooling unit and back. It is controlled by 62.1-1 for TFP pump 1, 62.1-2 for TFP pump 2, available in HB1 and HB2. MCB is available in HB1 and HB2. Traction converter pump 1, pump 2. They are available near traction converter, side of the traction converter, either pump or water pump, oil cooling system or water cooling system, to circulate the traction converter oil or water to cooling unit and back to the SR, controlled by 63.1-1 for SR1, 63.1-2 for SR2. This MCP is available in HP1, HP2. Axial converter number 3 feeds MCP1, MCP2, scavenger bearer 1 and scavenger bearer 2, 3 phase scavenger bearer 1 and 2, and charger. MCPs are available under truck below machine room number 1 and machine room number 2. They will create MR pressure 8 to 10, was controlled by 47.1-1 in HP1 for MCP1, 47.1-2 in HP2 for MCP2. And scavenger blowers, 3 phase scavenger blower number 1, located near TMB1 in machine room number 2, will clean the dust from filters of TMB1 and OCP2, controlled by 55.1-1 in HP1. Similarly, 3 phase scavenger blower number 2, located near TMB2, machine room number 1, to clean the dust from filters of TMB2 and OCP1, is controlled by MCB 55.1-2 in HP2. Charger. So, charger is available in bar 2, inside the bar 2, to charge the batteries and control circuits, protected by 2 MCBs, input 100, output 110. So 100 was located in HP2 or in some of the locos on bar 2. So 110 is available in SP2. Output breaker is available in SP2. If one of the axial converter isolated, the load will share. The load will share into two groups. In one group blowers, and in second group pumps and charger will come. The healthy converters will share the load. If axial converter 1 isolated, converter 2 will feed blowers OCP 1 and 2, TMB 1 and 2, and scavenger blower 1 and 2. And axial converter 3 will feed MCP 1 and 2, TFP pump 1 and 2, SR pump 1 and 2, pumps and charger CHPA. Similarly, if converter 2 isolated, converter 1 will feed blowers, converter 3 will feed pumps and charger. Similarly, axial converter 3 isolated, converter 1 will feed blowers, converter 2 will feed pumps and charger. How the load sharing will take place through axial conductors we will see. Normal condition. The supply from axial converter 1, 52/5 close position. These 4/1 and 4 will be open. Supply axial converter 1 will feeds the OCP1, OCP. Similarly, axial converter 2 through 52/1, supply will come to the TMB1. In this enclosed position, supply will come to the TFP pump 1, pump 2, converter pump 1, pump 2. Converter 2 will feed the TMB1, 1, 2, TFP pump 1, pump 2, converter pump 1, pump 2. Axial converter 3 will feed the charger MCP1, MCP2. And this will be in closed position. This was open. It's also open to 52.4 bar 2. The supply will be given to the scavenging device also. Converter 3 will feed battery charger MCP1, MCP2, and scavenging device 1 and 2. If any one of the converter isolated, for example, 2 isolated. This will be in closed position. Now this turn to close. So converter 1 will feed OCP1, OCP2 through these breakers TMB1 and scavenging bearer number 1, scavenging bearer 2, TMB1, TMB2 will also will come into the service. So all blowers will come into the one group. It was fed by the auxiliary converter 1. Similarly, auxiliary converter 3 will feed the charger MCP1, MCP2 through this contactor. It will feed TFP pump 1, pump 2, converter pump 1, pump 2. All pumps and charger will feed by the IC converter 2. These two will be open position. And this also open. It's also open. If converted to isolated, the load was shared by other converters with the help of auxiliary contactors. We can see here, with the help of auxiliary contactors, how the load will share if one of the converter was isolated. The supply from main winding goes to the auxiliary, and from there converter 1, converter 2, converter 3, we have seen how the load will go and share. We have seen for auxiliary winding we have taken one more winding, single phase AC supply. For auxiliary winding, we have taken one more winding of single phase AC supply. 1000 volts was stepped down to 415. That supply will be given to the single phase motors and starter devices. Single phase machine blowers, single phase scavenging blowers and starter devices, cab heaters, cab fans, ventilator blowers. We can see here the single phase supply, which is from auxiliary winding, will feed to the machine blower 1 and 2, machine blower number 1 to cool the machine room to limit the temperature of control electronics to 70 degrees centigrade. The MCB is 54.1 bar 1 in HP 1. Similarly, in machine room blower number 2, in machine room 2, to cool the machine room number 2, located MCB located in HP2 54.1 bar 2. This coming to S1 and 2, single phase coming to S1 and 2. To clean the dust from filters of machinable air. This machinable air will take the air from outside through a filter and they will cool the machine 1 and 2. These machinable air will clean the dust from filters of machinable air number 1 and 2. These MCBs are 56.1 bar 1, 56.1 bar 2 in HP1, HP2. And study devices, cab heaters. Available in the both cabs, the 450 volt supply will be given to the heaters to warm up the cab. Same 450 volt supply again step down to 110 volts AC. This supply will be given to the crew fans, two in each cab for crew ventilation, and two ventilator blowers are provided in the cab to expel the outside air into the cab through a heater. Switch on heater, hot air will come. If you are not switch on heater, the normal air, atmosphere will come into the cab. These MCBs available in HP1. Next, the supply. Main winding, step down, go to the hotel load winding. Hotel load. This hotel load facility was available in all WIP 5 locos in some of WIP 7. So, this supply will be given to the coaches. So, hotel load. Unused compatible loads such as coach lighting, mobile laptop chargers, air conditioning, pumps, heaters, pantry load, refrigerators, battery charger, all these equipments will call as hotel load. This supply will be given by three ways. One is self-generation system, end-on generation system. So EOC placing two generators in end, with the help of generators the supply will be given. Third system, head-on generation system. The supply will be given from loco by keeping one extra winding, hotel load winding. So from hotel load winding it will be stepped down. So in head-on generation provided locos, so two hotel load converters are provided, two additional windings will be there. The supply will be taken from main winding, from there it will convert single phase to three phase. That three phase supply will be given to the coaches. Here you can see here loco with the hotel load connectors, power cables. Power cable connectors and UIC. Uninterrupted cable. Control system. This UIC was controlled by one MCB. 129.1 in SP2. You can see MCB 129.1 in SP2 for hotel load control system. power connectors. The power which was generated through hot load converters, through power cables, the power car, the supply will be given to the coaches. Two converters will be there. From there, the supply will be given to the coaches in HOG system, head-on generation system. So with this three-phase low-cost power circuit was completed. Thank you.